Hello! Today I've got a less wearable look for you, or at least I'm going out grocery shopping in a moment, so this is going to be a wearable look for me. But anyways, yeah, this is inspired by a fireplace. I thought it'd be, you know, just, you know, a nice thing to do in winter, to do something warm. Yeah, that's how my brain works. Yeah, it obviously doesn't actually give warmth, but I think it looks really cool. And yeah, I really hope you enjoy watching this. One thing, if you want to do this as well and you don't have face paint, don't worry. You can also use liquid lipstick or actual eyeliner to do your eyeliner. But yeah, let's get started. As always, I'm just going to start out with priming my eyelids using concealer and a translucent loose powder this time, because I'm really focusing on the eyes. I'm not going to show the face makeup because it's just really, you know, normal makeup. And yeah, this is really all about the eye look. Nevertheless, I will put everything I've used on both my face and my eyes listed in the description box down below, just in case you were wondering. And yeah, so pretty much just blended out the concealer with a beauty blender and then applied powder with a powder proof. And because I'm going to use bright colors, which I really want to pop, I'm going to use a white base. This is a Lit Lingerie by NYX in the shade Better the Bone, which I'm blending out with an eyeshadow brush. Alternatively, you could use a white concealer, a actual white, you know, cream eye primer. Even a very creamy white pencil would do the work. Just anything that gives a very pale, sort of sticky base. And the eyeshadows I'm using are all from the 120 color palette by BH Cosmetics. This is the first edition version of that palette. And as you can see just now, it contains more than enough colors to create every sort of flames I would ever want. So I'm starting out with the yellow with a large fluffy blending brush, and I'm just applying it until it's deep enough, almost up to my eyebrow. Then after that I'm switching to a slightly smaller blending brush and orange, and yeah, same deal, I'm just applying it and just layering it until I think the color is intense enough. I am being careful not to go over the yellow completely, still want the yellow border there. And then I'm switching to an even tinier blending brush with a shade that's pretty much somewhere between very, very, very deep orange and red. And I'm also blending this over top of the other orange and almost up to the yellow. And if at any point you go over the yellow on accident, you can just go back with a tiny brush and add some more yellow as I'm doing here. So yeah, basically just go back and forth and keep blending until you're happy with it. Then the eyelid is really simple. In the inner corner I'm applying a silvery grey shade, and then for the rest of it I'm just patting very dark grey eyeshadow all over it. Nothing complicated, just keep packing it on until it's dark enough. And then to blend the lid and the crease together, I'm using the darker shade of red from the palette. Again with a very small blending brush, this one is slightly firmer than the other one I was using earlier. This shade of red actually had a little bit of shimmer in it, which I think actually adds to the look. I mean, it's supposed to be fire after all. And I'm really keeping this below the edge of the orange. I really still want the orange to be visible. And yeah, just making sure it's all blended. And just dusting off the fallout. And then it's time for the eyeliner part. I'm using face paint for it, but like I said at the beginning, you could also use liquid lipstick or actual eyeliner. And yeah, all about the color, by the way. I wanted to do a brown brick fireplace. You could also do a grey brick fireplace, or if you don't want to be all difficult with your eyeliner, you could just do a modern metal fireplace and just do a, you know, metallic black eyeliner or something like that. But yeah, I went for a brown brick one, so I just made an easy sort of large thick pink liner first, and then started outlining it with a very tiny, tiny brush. This is actually a nail art brush and black face paint. And really all I can advise you with this part and also the next part is just take your time with it. Try to lean your elbow on something so you can really keep your hand steady. And just don't rush, because, you know, this is quite difficult to do. Especially if you didn't do it often yet. So yeah, just take your time with it. And then for the bricks, the trick to it, I think, is really to keep making straight lines. And also keep the distance between the lines even, because that's how it would be with actual regular bricks. And this really gives off the idea of a brick wall. And then I wanted something extra in the crease, so I decided to add some flames. Well, not really flames, more like the suggestion of flames. Pretty much sort of swirly, wavy lines. And I just kept as little pressure as possible on my brush. And it really helps in making them look random and, you know, sort of thinner at the edges. And yeah, just nice and wiggly. Also, I did actually do these differently, like the little flame thingies on both of my eyes. I think it would, you know, look less natural for fire if it would actually be completely mirrored on the other eye. In terms of colors, I'm just using pretty much the same colors as I did for the whole eyeshadow blending. And I'm really keeping the yellow at the top, because it's the brightest color. And then once I'm happy with that, it's time for mascara. I'm using the Colossal Cat Eye Mascara by Maybelline. I did want my lashes to be there, but I didn't want to add falsies because, you know, I just did all that work on the eyeliner. I didn't want to cover it with fake hair. And then for my lash line, waterline, I decided to go for a very dark, dark brown eye pencil. Thought it was better suitable with the brown brick eyeliner than actual black eyeliner. So yeah, I'm just filling in my top waterline first. Always a nice view, and also don't forget about the inner corner, and then also filling in the lower waterline. And it's already the final step of the tutorial. So here's the final result. I'm actually surprised about how almost wearable this turned out, especially from a distance. And also I'm surprised how well I managed to do the little flames randomly. I'm so bad at doing stuff randomly. I'm way better at, you know, actually following a pattern or something. But yeah, anyway, I really like how this look turned out. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you'd like to, you can also subscribe to my channel. For now, as always, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!